Now, the same thing happens to your day-to-day training, right? Your sort of weekly volume, how much you run in a week. We all respond differently to that, right? You may know some people that run higher mileage, others run lower mileage. There is no magic mileage. Everybody is different in our durability and our ability to run a certain volume of mileage. Our life schedule is different. When my son was born, I couldn't run as much as I did before because I couldn't get to sleep, right? And so you have to adjust what it is. So when you look at how do I respond to this, again, I think it's good to pull out the program. And I do a lot of training just by minutes, but you can estimate the mileage if you will, or you could do this by time, but this is mileage per week, right? And so it kind of shows for me what this program would have been. Now, I'm really good right now between 30 and 40 miles a week is a good sweet spot for me at this point in my life. I've run a ton more than that before, but at this point, that's kind of a sweet spot. When I go 50 to 70, that's sort of a danger point for me. And so if I look at this, all of a sudden I notice I got 40 to 50, 40 to 50, 40 to 50, 40 to 45. Those are starting to move toward the higher end of my comfort zone. So I might say, you know what, I need to take a break. I need to have a down week. You've probably read about people cycling their mileage up and down to provide that. I feel like in this program, I would probably need that. I would need to go ahead at the outset and say, this is a recovery week for me. And I would simply, boom, I'm not running that day. I take another day off. That works really well for me for injury prevention. Other people might just reduce the volume of each day. You can do it in a number of ways, whatever might work for you. I would just change things so that I reduce that volume a little bit. Again, I'm objective if I'm up here. Once I'm in here, I'm less objective. So go ahead, plan it out, take a look at it, and think about, is that good? The more durable you are, the less you have to worry about these recovery weeks. The less durable, I'm not that durable, you better plan these recovery weeks. You better plan recovery days. Because the number one enemy in running is injury. If you will just stay healthy, you will run much faster. You don't have to do anything magical, just don't get hurt. You will continue to get better and better. And then you can tweak all the fun stuff and really get to your best. But you have to stay healthy. This is a good way to start ensuring that you don't get caught up into chasing mileage when you really need a break. Does that make sense? So, some people need 2 weeks up, 1 week down. Some people 3 weeks up, 1 week down. Some people 4 weeks up. It doesn't matter. You probably know based on your injury history. The more injured you are, take more down weeks. Cycle them in, plan them, schedule them now. Schedule them once you're up here so that when you get here, you don't freak out. And you might even make a note. Hey, remember in week one, we decided this should be a down week to protect from injury. Even if you're feeling like a million bucks, because that's when injury comes, isn't it? It's always when you're like, yes, I'm there, I feel great, it's happening. Hurt, right? That's how it happens. It's the worst thing in running because it's just when you feel good. Go ahead and plan it. And that way you typically will take that recovery that you need. Questions on that one?
Do you need to get hung up over the, I read a lot about the percentage of your long run miles to your weekly volume, and it's always a struggle for me because if I try to follow that 30, 35% number that I see a lot, I can't get the two to work.
Yeah.
If you're running 30, 40 miles a week.
The answer is no. The percent of weekly volume that you do as your long run came from elite runners 40, almost 50 years ago now. In fact, Arthur Lydiard, the great coach that I've toured with, all of his runners ran roughly 100 miles a week. Now, they were really good, and their average training pace was like 6 minutes a mile. So from a volume standpoint, that's not that many hours of running, right? Many of you run enough hours to be the same. But they had this one loop that was 22 miles, and that was their long run route. And so out of that came this sort of originally the 20 to 25% rule. Well, it just happened to be that if that long run route would have been 18, it would have been 18%. So it was just sort of that became the standard, but it doesn't have any sort of physiological, like, you have to do this. And so if you're more normal, right, and you run 30 miles a week, let's say, and you're preparing for a marathon, well, then that's going to be much higher percentage of your total volume. So I don't think we can be as clean cut as we wish we could and say, you know what, if you want to be successful, just do 25% as your long run. You can't do that. You really have to think about, what is that run doing for me? Individual, that's an individual workout to help you, as opposed to percentages. I'm not a big fan of percentages anymore. And that I work with a lot of different runners, right? I work with some people who run 10 miles a week, and that's run walk 10 miles a week. And I work with some people who run 120, 130 miles a week. So I just think we're all so individual. We better just think about what's going to help me get ready for the race than worrying about the equations too much. But that's a really good question, because I think sometimes we get nervous about, am I doing it right? And you read a lot of stuff and things start conflicting, and it's very confusing sometimes. So I just think about, what do you need to do? If you're training for a marathon, you have to do certain workouts to get ready. It doesn't matter if you're running 2 days a week or 10 times a week, you have to do those workouts. So